Why do you think some traditional rulers find it difficult to speak truth to power?
With due respect, if you don't believe in God, all evils and all is with you. But if you believe in God, and that's why I said in one of my previous interviews, the Lagos State government now, in future, by the grace of God Almighty Allah, nobody, I repeat, nobody dared say no to me to any reasonable thing according to my own wisdom. Because I don't have a reservoir of knowledge. I may see a boy of 30 who may have superior argument to defeat what I feel making, inshallah. And any good Muslim, you should remember that God says, Yoruba says, Ashe nibi empo la osimo. Death can catch up on anybody at any time. And you should behave like that. And train your children in the way of God, sound education, and be good to people, or to be no nonsense to anybody. That is the truth. Me, I don't deceive anybody. Well, if I tell you my opinion, that is your own headache. I don't care.
Let's still talk about the traditional rulers. There have been instances where traditional rulers have been censured for acts unbecoming of their office. What needs to happen during the selection process to ensure that people of good character, only good people of good character, are selected as traditional rulers? Past,
particularly in this house. There are some set of people we call Ibiga. They are born in the palace. They are entitled to everything in this palace except the cap. They knew the in and out of the palace. And when anything happens, they are the first and the oldest to tell the most senior white cap chief by way who will get in touch with Ashokmon. And for some time, they have been watching what some all potential princes hope to be Obas, except they will not tell you the truth. But they have been placing them under surveillance. They know which one is good, which one will has a very good welfare or something, which one will be a future good Oba. But Allah knows everything. It is those people that, before the British, they pick somebody, then put him there.
How can we stop the politicization of the traditional institution?
Well, it depends on what you call politics. The mere fact that you are the holder and head of the family, even in the ordinary family setup, it is politics. But partisan, God will bless you for that question. You know, many people do accuse me that I'm anti-PDP. There is nothing like that.
The question I was trying to ask, should traditional rulers get involved in politics?
That's what I'm telling you. It depends on what you call politics. There is partisan politics and there is palace politics. I am neck deep in palace politics and I cannot come out of it.
But partisan politics, no.
I will never be rubber stamped to anybody. Politicians don't quarrel. They only disagree. I'm telling you. They only disagree to agree later.
What you're saying is whoever gets involved in their issue becomes...
Be honest and tell them the truth. That even within the same party, don't you see koni among them there? Be close to your God and pray. Because all these politicians, they can mess you up at any time. Me, I'm not against anybody, but I will always tell them the truth.
How can the traditional ruler maintain his integrity? Or indeed anyone?
Have faith in God, be of good character, know what is right and what is wrong. Be very, very prayerful. You will not have any problem.
Which of the former Obas of Lagos inspired you the most and why?
All of them, and the most gentle of all the former Obas was the late Oba Faolu, who became Oba in 1933 and died in 1949.
So tell us about the relationship between the Bini and the Eko people, yes.
And the first Oba of Lagos is a male descendant of Oba of Benin, and very close person to him. He sent him on a mission here. And that's why we have a song. Omoko moko ni wao. Awa kinsho mo abidanum. Ode bini no bi baba awasi. Oba lo bi si be kinshari. Enyigbo, that's any an installation of any oba. That song is always there. And anybody wants to be a chief or anything, oba, at that enowa. When we finish the ceremony, we do like this. That thing we are doing, they are saluting the Oba of Benin. That does not mean that Benin are the owners of Lagos. But we are part and parcel of in the past, not the present. And the late Oba of Benin of the blessed memory, very, very nice. The Baba took me as a son. And by the grace of God, the one to be now, he knows very well. Because the Baba tells him every time, hold tight to Oba of Lagos. And we are very, very close.
You retired from the Nigeria Police Force as an assistant inspector general of police. What do you think of that institution now?
The Nigerian police, let me tell you. Let me be frank. Nigerian police is as good as anything, provided the government provide all what is required to do the job. One, the members of the force are ready to do the job. The Nigerian public are prepared to offer useful cooperation, assistance, and information for the police to achieve success. That is the truth. We have many capable and hardworking officers, like this number one IG now. There is no operational or mobile officer who will not do well as Inspector General of Police. But he has to realize one thing. He should know he was a civilian before he came to the job, and he's going to leave the job and go back. As a leader, people will come and tell you all different stories. You put down your head, know which one is likely to be true, and be patient. Tobadeju, Warimo, you should not be in a hurry.
Describe to us the police of your dream.
You see the policemen in Lagos. Look at all the sources they have been. It is because of the logistic support. If you know what Ambode is doing, which is not his work, it's supposed to be federal something. That's why I was very happy 3 days ago when I heard that he said they should allow states to go. There is nothing like resource control. They should let us have proper federation. Believe me, but to remain as one entity. And any part of the state where things are not, that we should assist them. Maybe somebody has forgotten. I will even remind him and Bola Tinubu. During the time of Jakande, there were some millions of naira we borrowed to Borno State. But even now, we now tell them to write it off with the condition of what is happening in Borno State now. And God will bring it to an end. That was the spirit during the time of Goni. Jakande borrowed their money from Lagos State. But Lagos State is very bold. And we have just started. You will see, the discovery of that oil is still going to be in many places. It's what God has shown to me in dream. And I told them from the word go, Ambode is going to do it. Even himself too has spoken to him that, look, all those who are against you, that you not become governor or something, I say, Father, leave them, draw them nearer. God has placed you there. And he's going to do it by the grace of God.